Hey, welcome to Man Kitchen Recipes. I'm Kevin, and today we're going to do, I don't know, I've been on this sandwich kick. I've been making some crazy sandwiches. I had that meatball sandwich, that baked BLT, the packed and stacked BLT. I did the stuffed burgers. I did the fire eater burger. I did the smokehouse bourbon burger. I don't know. Whatever it was. Anyway, if you've seen it, you've seen it. Anyway, we're gonna use the Brisket Pellet Grill today. If you can hear this thing going on and off, that's part of that controller. It keeps the temperature like that. Off. On. And that helps control the temperature to give you a nice even temp. I'm really liking this little pellet grill. I've used it a lot. I'm not doing big cooks off of it. I do my big cooks off my Lone Star Grills. But anyway, so I am closing in on 10,000 subscribers, and thank you to everyone that's helped me get this far so far. If you're not a subscriber, please consider it. If you like to grill outside, if you like to barbecue, I show you how to do some very simple cooks. I don't use tons of ingredients. I usually use whatever you usually have around your house, and if you don't, I don't mind using packaged, jarred stuff. You know, some people are purists and they have an issue with that. Oh, you should home make everything. I'm telling you, it still turns out delicious, and that's just how we do it. We make it easy for you to follow along. I show you how. I think outside the box, give you different ideas on stuff to cook and how to cook, so you don't just do the same plain old burgers, plain old ribs, plain old chicken, plain old barbecue. All right, so hit that subscribe button. Go check out some of my other videos. I even do some reviews. I did a review on this Brisket pellet grill. It's a pretty sweet little grill. And anyway, as this video goes, if you like what I'm doing, hit that like button too. So subscribe, like, let's do this. Today I'm doing, okay, you've heard of the McRib sandwich, right? I've done a rib sandwich in the past, probably a couple of years ago. And this one's gonna be different because I've been on this sandwich kick. This one's got a French loaf with everything bagel seeds and everything on top. And we're gonna have our baby back rib, McRib, anti-McRib sandwich. This is how a rib sandwich should be made. You don't have to have that pre-formed pork or whatever that is in the McRib. We're gonna use a real baby back rib. Stick around, this is how we do it.
All right, we got our baby back ribs here. Grab a corner or wherever you can and peel it right up. Piece of cake. To me, that's the easiest way. You can take a butter knife and try to get it underneath. All right, I'm gonna kinda get that started. Work your finger in there, just like that, all the way across. And a lot of people will just tell you, just take it and pull it up from the center. And that's how easy it is. And since these are baby backs, you know, you can cut these little, there's a little tiny bone here at the end. You can remove that. In fact, I think I will go ahead and remove it right at that bone. Get rid of that bone right there. All right, so we're doing two baby backs. Okay, I am not gonna put any binder on here. You can put yellow mustard, you can use olive oil, you can use just about anything you like. Cut that off. Okay. All right, so the rub I'm gonna use on these today is Texas Dust Oil Dust, and I'm using the Barnyard Pimp. All right, so you know, it's not rocket science. You don't have to go too thick on the bottom, but you want to get a good coating, and then flip them over, do the other side. You can get the sides just like that. There you go, piece of cake, right?
Okay, that's how easy it is to prepare your ribs, your baby back ribs. St. Louis ribs are a little more, gotta do a little more things to it. Anyway, here they are. They've been resting about 10 or 15 minutes, getting a little sweaty. You wanna let them get you want to let them sweat a little bit, at least 10 to 15 minutes before you get them on the grill. I like to wrap because I like getting that extra tenderness. So what I'm going to do now, 225 degrees and on this brisket pellet grill, pellet smoker, 225 degrees for the first, I'll probably go 2.5 to 3 hours, then we'll wrap it up. Total cook time is going to be right around 4 to 5 hours, just depending on how they look. And yeah, they're super easy to do. If you have a pellet grill, baby back ribs is a must to cook. We're just doing it in a different way today. We're going to make a sandwich out of one of these. The other one is for my niece. All right, let's get these on the grill. Here it is, Brisk It. I'm not doing a brisket. That's the name of this pellet smoker. Okay, let's get these baby back ribs in here. 225 degrees. Okay, so low and slow for these babies. Just want to get them in there. Hear that kicking on and off? That's what I love about this grill. Pretty sweet. All right, we'll probably see in about, 3 hours. All right, we're right at the 3 hour mark. We're still running at 225. Oh yeah, look at that. The color on those look great. So we're gonna pull these off and go to the next step. And while I'm out here, I'm gonna go ahead and turn up my temp to, I'm gonna let this go up to 250. Set. All right, so we are gonna treat these like you would do a 3-2-1 before we wrap them. And we're just gonna add some brown sugar in there. Gonna add some honey. Okay. You can use parquet, but I went to the store to get parquet and they did not have any. So we're just gonna use real butter. Real butter works great as well. Take our baby back ribs and we're gonna lay them in right there. Now, you can pick off these little black bits if you want, or you can leave them, it doesn't really matter. Like I said, we're not doing a competition cook. Looks a little better if you take them off, but not critical. And then we're gonna do this side. Not as quite as heavy with the brown sugar and everything. Now, I should have done it before, but this one's going to be for my sandwich. So I'm going to do a little bit of a cheat right here. And I am going to cut on each bone. I'm just going to put a little score mark on each one. And the reason I'm doing this is because when we make our sandwich, well, you know, we don't want a bone in our sandwich, right? So I'm going to get this wrapped up. Want a nice tight wrap. Okay. You got to be careful when you do the ends so you don't get the bones poking through your foil. And just in case you have that issue, I am going to double wrap these. Okay, I'm gonna fold the second one, I'm going to fold under. Okay, when we put them back out on the grill, they're going to go meat side down. Okay, I'll get the other one done up and we'll see you out at the grill. I'll just lay them back in the way we had them. Again, you know, these do fit lengthwise. So you could easily do 3 to 4. You could even put a fifth one up here on that top shelf in this brisket if you wanted to. All right. So we're going to let this go 1.5 hours to maybe 1 hour and 45 minutes. We'll be back. Yeah. There's a little surprise for the day. Started raining and had to move my little brisket out here. Back underneath the patio. Fun. Over a tiny bit. I didn't show making it because I just did a bourbon barbecue sauce. 1 cup to 1/4 cup. 1 cup of Sweet Baby Ray's, 1/4 cup of bourbon. Put it in here and let it simmer. Burn off some of the alcohol. Catch some smoke. We'll put that on these ribs. We'll be back in a little bit. All right, there's our bourbon barbecue sauce. See how these are doing. See if we can get those bones out. Fresh out, it'll be hot. All right, yeah. All right, now see the difference in these bones? These bones have pulled back a little bit. And let me just see how easy or not easy they're gonna be to come out. Okay. I'm gonna take these bones out. They are hot.
Okay, so basically I got some gloves on. These are cotton gloves and some nitrile gloves. These are food safe, powder-free gloves. Anytime you're touching hot food, you wanna, if you wanna touch them, you see guys on barbecue, they usually have a cotton glove underneath. And then we can more easily pull these bones out, not quite so darn hot on the fingers. Okay. Some of these on the ends too, there are other bones. You wanna make sure you're gonna get all of that out too. So like on this other end, when it's pulling, it looks like it's pulling some of the meat out, which it is, but there's also bone right here. You wanna make sure that is out because we are making a sandwich out of this one. Okay, now I'm gonna get my bourbon barbecue sauce. I'm just gonna go ahead and pour this over this part right here. Flip that over. Okay, same thing. Going to make sure I get a nice covering of the bourbon barbecue sauce. Don't be shy with it. Got plenty. So that sauce has probably been on an hour and a half. Kind of helps burn the alcohol out of that bourbon. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to also leave this in here just for convenience. I'm going to roll these edges up. All right, now I'm gonna throw this back in. I'm gonna take the other ones off. They've been on long enough. And we'll finish this up here in a minute. All right, here we go. There is our bourbon barbecue baby back ribs. Here is our everything French bread loaf. Look at that. All right, let's see how well I can do. There we go, all right. There's our French bread. Everything bagel French bread. Okay, here we go. There we go. Look at that. What do you think of that so far? I'm thinking that right there is worth a smashing that like button, right? So this is just a pork barbecue baby back sandwich. So we're gonna lay out some red onion that I just cut up. And hey, gotta have pickles on a pork sandwich, right? Now you can add whatever you like. I like pickles. I like red onion. These are dill pickles. Let's make it messy. Let's get some bourbon barbecue sauce on top of all of this. Get it nice and wet. Look at that. All right, looks good. You can put as much or as little as you want on there. And here you go. Look at that. All right, Mickey D. That right there is a rib sandwich. We've got our Jim Beam in there. We've got some Sweet Baby Ray's on there. Red onion. Pickles on an everything French loaf. What do you think of that? Let's do a taste test of this. I will give it a cut, obviously. I could try eating it, holding the whole thing, but I know. Okay. I'll go ahead and cut this in front of you. Okay, now you can make your sandwiches as big or as thin as you want, depending on how many people are eating it. And look at this. Oh yeah, look at that. All right, let's take a taste of this. All right, well, it's still raining outside. Wasn't expecting that today, but hey, we'll just do this inside. I got that monster sandwich over there. Look at that. Let's just take a bite of it for you. That bourbon barbecue sauce, I'm telling you, it's just good. You do have to burn it off. I mean, you do want to let it simmer and get some of that alcohol flavor, the alcohol out of it, but you still get the flavor. And man, I'm telling you, this is so good. That everything bun, French bread. You're not going to find this at any fast food restaurant. Not like this. Thanks for watching. You know, I think this cooked for a total of 5 hours, but it's worth it. Ribs are just amazing anyway, and making a sandwich out of them,
slice those bones, get those bones tender and get them out of there. Make a sandwich. All right. Thanks for watching. Help me hit that 10,000 subscriber list. Hit the subscribe button. If this doesn't get you to subscribe, I don't know what else will. Come back, look at my other videos. Maybe you'll change your mind if you haven't already subscribed. If you have, thank you so much. And I hope you have a great day.